New data shows international airfares are becoming more affordable, but the cost of domestic airfares is creeping up. Here's aviation editor Blake Johnson.
Beck, it's a turbulent year for airlines. A drop in domestic competition is causing a rise in airfares. This as Qantas launches a new sale and route out of Melbourne.
Qantas targets North and South America in its latest sale and launches Melbourne to Honolulu three times a week, replacing the twice a week on Jetstar.
The plane Qantas is using, it's an older Airbus A330. It's not quite as good for helping passengers overcome jet lag compared to the Jetstar Boeing 787.
Launch fares start at $1,050 return, roughly 60% more expensive than Jetstar. More than 30 Qantas routes are on sale for 7 days, including Sydney or Brisbane to Los Angeles for $1,200 return.
If you're flexible on the days you travel, you'll probably find a lot of seats available to buy with Qantas points rather than dollars.
20 years ago, the cheapest Sydney-London airfare with Flight Centre was $1,300. That's increased a few hundred dollars since, but the average wage has grown much faster, from $953 a week to almost $2,000. That means 20 years ago, flying Sydney to London was about 1.5 weeks' wage, now just 4 days' worth.
International airfares is that they've come down from January to June by 13%. And in the month of July, they've continued to fall again another 5%.
Here, domestic economy airfares are compared to 2003. Prices went above in COVID, dropped when borders reopened, and are now edging up, not helped by the collapse of Bonza, then Rex, in less than 6 months. Blake Johnson, 7 News.